Hey everyone, Corey here, and today I'm going to be doing a solo live comp on Shangri-La. I'm going to be showing you guys a solo strategy on how to get, how to start out and how to get far. I do have a disclaimer to make though, as in this map, it's different each time. The perks go in a different area, the boxes go in a different area. So sometimes it might be easier, sometimes it might be harder, and I'm not sure how it's going to end up. You're gonna have to make changes to the solo strat depending on how your thing is, but I'm gonna show you the main run through, I guess, and let's get started. So here's where we start out. Up there is the pack a punch. You only really need to worry about it when you have to pack a punch a gun, but we don't really have to do that right now. So first round we're gonna start knifing all the zombies. The reason why we do this is because knifing gives you the most points. As you can see, a knife is 130 points. Fucker. Knife is 130 points, and fix the windows. Now it only lets you fix the windows, I think, 4 times the first round. I might be mistaken, it might be a little more. But we're gonna knife each round. And there we get luck points. And you don't wanna rebuild. I mean, right here it's not giving us points, so you don't really need to rebuild that unless it's gonna give you points. So just wait to rebuild the next round. I'm gonna have to turn on my AC though because it's hot, and I apologize if it's annoying, but I need it, or else I can't record. So new round starts, start rebuilding, it'll give you the points. But you wanna make sure that the first two rounds, these are all boarded. Now, next round it takes 2 knives, so 1, 2. Now, if you're a type of person that can't really last that long, you want to get as much points as possible, so you might want to start shooting the zombies. Shoot them in the legs, they'll give you 10 points per shot, and then 130 for the knife. That is the easiest way to get a lot of points. Right now, I'm just going to knife the first 2 rounds, and then I'll do that on the 3 rounds, that way so I have ammo, and then we'll venture off halfway through when I get overrun by zombies. Well, that's not good. Bitch. Sometimes it's hard. The knife isn't that accurate and sucks. Bitch. But you want to make sure they don't double hit you. You want to make sure that if you're going to go in for the second knife or whatever, be in 100% health, because if they hit you before you hit them, you're going to die. But you should be fine. Also, I jump back, as you can see. I like knife and jump. Sometimes that like helps you. At least helps you like get away from crawlers and stuff. But not so much. Here it's not paying us. So we're just going to knife. And then step back and then knife again. Always make sure you, rebuild health, or the zombie might hit you without you knowing. If there's 2 zombies, you might want to just shoot them. But here we're at 2,500 points. We're going to wait for this to switch. We're going to start rebuilding. Get as much points as possible. And then we're going to start heading out and doing this round and getting the stuff we need. I'm going to build this. Here you can just shoot your entire clip into a zombie. You can actually get 2 clips. Nope. Yeah, 2 clips to kill a zombie. But we want to be able to knife them. So it's a clip and 2 knives. Here's the max ammo. That's most likely going to happen, so you can waste all your ammo. It's a clip. Fuck. Going to get overrun. It's a clip and 2 knives. You kind of don't want to do that. So, oh shit. So what we're going to do is we're just going to actually go get a good gun. So you want to come off to the left. Now this is where it changes. If it's up to you which way you go, I guess. I like left because I like getting the 74U. Oh, also here, the zombies get stuck there. I keep forgetting about that. So you can go that way and kill them. Knife. Alright, so like I said, you can shoot a clip into them, maybe even clip and a half. Yeah, it's a clip and a half and then a knife to get a lot of points. Oh fuck, I knifed the wrong zombie. But just be careful when knifing a lot of zombies, because you might get the wrong zombie. Alright, now we're at 4,000 points. What we're going to do now, the perks change everywhere. So if you're Juggernaut here, that makes it better. If not, like it isn't for me, then it's gonna make your life a little more difficult, and that sucks, but whatever. Here's a double point. I'll show you later what to do with the monkeys. The monkeys come and steal your perks, your power-ups. I'll just tell you later when it comes to that. But we're gonna open this door for 1,000 points. We're then going to come in here and get the 74U. 74U is my favorite. It's one of the strongest guns. I'm going to open this door for 1,000. Then we're going to come over here and open this for 1,250. And then here's the power room. So we're going to turn on the power. Right here is a switch. And right here is a switch. Now what we're going to do is save up our money for the Bowie knife. And when we get that, I'll let you know why. And then we're going to open this door and we get some more money. But now that we have an actual gun, what we want to do is we want to go back into the world. This is like the underground. We want to go back upstairs, up top, whatever you want to say. And we're going to start running around just so we don't die, so we can get some more points. Because we need to get some juggernauts. Where did the zombie go? I think he jumped down. Yes, the zombies can jump down here. You just want to shoot. Explain it to you real quick. It's for every round, that's how many bullets you use for a real gun. So this, it's 2 bullets, and then you can knife and you'll get the most points. The reason why you want to do that is for every point that hits it, for every bullet that hits a zombie, that's 10 points, and then the knife is 130. Whereas if you kill them with just the gun, it's not. So it's always good that you knife for the deaths. Come on. You know, it's good that you always get the knife, the death, like the death hit as a knife. That'll give you the missed points. It'll give you 130, like I said. Instead of, I think it's 100 or something. But here we're just shooting 3 times. You fucker. Sometimes the zombies don't want to die. But it's 3 shots, like I said. But like I said, also, it doesn't always... Zombies are picky, I guess. I don't know. Sometimes bullets don't register. I don't know. I really don't know. Alright, we're going to get this insta-kill. Well, an insta-kill, you want a knife. If you get overrun by zombies, just shoot them. Not a big deal. Where's this monkey at? The monkeys do come for the power-ups, and we will bait them later. But they don't really hurt you. They just, like, punch you. They're like, you fucker, you took my perk. I keep saying perk, I'm sorry. They're like, fucker, you took my power-up. And then they slap you. And then they go away, so you don't have to worry about them chasing you like on escalation. But now that we got enough money, we need to open this door and we need to go find Juggernaut. In this map is really hard by yourself, and you're not going to survive without Juggernaut. It's right here. It all depends. There's perk there. There's perk there, and the box is down there. So once you figure all that out, and after you get Juggernaut, then you can start going. Now. You can step on those things and step back off to see if it, like, it goes in a certain pattern and it's different every time. Sometimes it's not where you want it to go, so I just walk through the thing, but it's a lot faster if you just run around the path, like, on the path. But like I said, sometimes the path doesn't go where you want it to go. Oh, fuck you. Alright, so this is the end of the round. We got Juggernaut. Now that we've gotten Juggernaut, what you want to do next is you want to buy Quick Revive. And the reason why you do this is because on solo, for those of you that have never played solo or don't know, it will revive you when you go down. You might fuck up sometimes, and if you do, that will, you know, you'll die. You'll go down in second chance. You'll have the nuke tube pistols, and you'll be able to kill all the zombies around you. And it'll give you a chance to be able to continue playing. I usually don't get it, but for the sake of the video, I will. Usually if I, you know, I'll go until I don't die, and then, I mean, until I die, I guess. And I don't really deserve a second life, I guess, because I didn't deserve it. That's how I feel. But we're just going to run around, kill all these zombies. Again, try to get the knife kill. It's kind of hard sometimes, you know, because there's a lot of zombies, and, yeah. And also, nuke. Not a good thing. Now the monkeys go berserk when you get perks, power-ups. Fuck, why do I keep saying perks? But like I was saying at the beginning of the video, it might be different. You know, a fire zombie might spawn differently than you, might fuck you over, a shrieker might spawn. And so telling you like this strat is going to work is, I mean, it all depends, I guess. I mean, it's a good strat, it's a very solid strategy. But it can be easily ruined, I guess, by just, you know, Juggernaut going in the wrong spot or something. You not getting the right gun, you not getting the right, you know, I don't even know, the the zombie spawning wrong and all that stuff. Trying to get the, and also, you know, if the monkey takes your power up, you know, if it's max ammo and you couldn't get to it real quick and the monkey takes it, then you're pretty much fucked, you know, so. So that's that, but, you know, like I said, it is a good strat. We're gonna come back down here, and now that we have enough money, we're gonna open that door that I said about. And, actually, no, we're not. We're gonna buy the Bowie knife, and the reason why we're gonna do this is because the Bowie knife is equivalent to either 10 or 11 levels. So now we only need, like, it's an insta-kill until level 10, at least. But also, it makes knife, like, shoot and then knifing, because then you don't have to guess how many shots, you can just tap knife, and you're always gonna be able to kill them with the knife as long as you're on level less than 10. After 10, then it depends on how many bullets you put into them, but it also gives you a lot more point, like it gives you the same amount of points, but you can kill more zombies. So as you can see, I just spent 3,000 on my thing, and I already got like 500 of it back in just like three zombies. So I mean, it's kind of like it costs a lot, but it's worth it. And it'll pay off. You'll get your 3,000 points back in like no time. Now, as you can see, we're running low on 74U ammo. Now, you don't want to switch out the ammo. Just keep the 74U. It's the best gun for now. You know, just keep running back down there and buying the ammo for it. I do hate the Bowie knife though, because it doesn't. Oh, here we go. We're gonna run around a knife. The Bowie knife is not as effective as the sickle. The sickle did like throw you farther, and it was good, but the Bowie knife seems really slow. Here's a shrieker. We need fucking ammo. When killing shriekers, the power-ups don't, okay, maybe it did. It doesn't seem like it did before. I don't know. Power-ups might work, but don't, just aim for the head, I guess. Just kill them like a normal zombie, just they take a lot more damage. Alright, so now we're saving up to open up the other side of the downstairs. Here you can just go on a knifing rage if you don't feel like shooting all the zombies. But I would advise you shoot some bullets into it, because like I said, it's easy points. There you go. It's easy points. As you can see, we're already back up to well over what we spent on the Bowie knife in just you know, a short amount of time. So alright, so we're going to come through here. And then you also keep the Bowie knife as long as you live, which in your solo, you know, until you actually die, you're going to have the Bowie knife. So we're going to open up this door, and now what we're going to do is we're going to buy the stakeout. And the reason why we're going to buy the stakeout is because it's insta-kill on level 10-ish, maybe two shots. But it's good for if you get fucked over, because like I said, it is a strong gun. It's as equivalent to your knife, you know, but it can be upgraded, unlike your knife, and, well, unless you have the Bowie knife, but, it can shoot a lot of zombies at once, I guess. So, to me, the stakeout is pretty much, like, your overpowered gun, and you should always have a overpowered gun, and, like, the ray gun, the baby ray, and a spraying gun, and the reason why you want both of that is because, the overpowered gun will kill the zombies when you get fucked over, and then the spraying gun will get you the points to buy better guns and stuff like that. So there we go. Now, in this game, I do not think there is a way to get all the perks. If there is, no one said anything about it. I haven't seen anything about it. So it's pretty annoying. Because I'm pretty sure that, yeah, I know there's at least 5 perks. There's Deadshot's in here. Flopper's in here. Flopper's not that effective in here, though, because there's not that many places that are in different like level grounds. So you can't really use it as much as you could in, say, Escalation or something. Yeah, that's what it's called. Carpenter. Now, Carpenter, we could have baited it. I got fucked over, you know, I knifed the zombie. Oh my gosh. But, try not to die. Also, you can run through these spikes if you get too fucked over, and then the zombies are stuck through them for at least a second or two. But yeah, as you can see, the whole knife effect thing is awesome. We're already back up to 3,500 points, which is just amazing. So then we're gonna start working on our other stuff, and our next step is to get better guns. Oh fuck. All right. To deal with the fire guy, there's two ways you can do it. One, you can shoot him, which takes waste your ammo. I'm gonna run through here. Waste your ammo. Or what you can do is you can just run right at him and then run away and he should explode. Now that's the fastest way to kill him, but not always the most effective because he's most likely going to hurt you when he explodes. And that's not good because if you run into like a zombie after you run away from him, you're going to die. So all I would say is just run from him. I'm not sure if I'm correct, but I believe he dies after... after each round, so you could do that. I'm not sure if that's the case, though. So that might not work. But, you know, just run from him. Worry about the other zombies. He's slow. He's not going to fuck you over. You know, he's not going to really cause much of a problem as long as you're not by him. And then you can just go back later and kill him if you want. There's the stamina. Now, I'm not really sure. I usually don't buy the perks. Oh, that's a step. I was like, what the hell happened? Alright. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go this way. Try to get the gun real quick. A new gun. Like I said, it's down in the water, so we're gonna open this way. In this map, you kind of want to open everything, so you have, ways out. We're just gonna hit the box real quick, see what we get, and then we're just gonna run away. Not important. Alright, we're gonna open this door for 1,000. Now, everything's open. Like I said, this map is actually really easy to run rape trains. Like, the whole map is a big-ass rape train, pretty much. But the problem is, depending on where the perks go, depending on what guns you have, depending on the guns it gives you, stuff like that, it makes it a lot harder, and it sucks, so. Just gonna knife those. Oh, fuck. See? And also, depending on which way this goes... Because sometimes this won't take you where you want to go. In fact, I've had it where it goes the same direction. Like, I went in from one side, and it brought me right back to that side. And that was annoying. So the game tries to fuck you over a lot. But it'll be fine. Alright, we need to advance. When running out of ammo, like I said, go this way. When running out of ammo, just switch your shotgun. Fucker? See, sometimes it doesn't always kill him, even though it's a one-shot. So, I'm going to be careful about that. But just keep buying the 74U ammo. That is going to be your baby until you get better. What the fuck keeps happening? It's that fire guy. I don't know where he's at. I guess he's up top. When you get close to him, that happens to your screen. So, but you could run a rape train the whole way around the big area like I'm doing right now. You can run smaller rape trains. I would not advise running there's one at the main room, like where you spawn, until you get the baby ray. Once you get the baby ray, I'll show you what to do, and then I'll pretty much end my chat, because then it's just simple. But until then, I don't know where they come from. Also, like I said before, don't rely on max ammos. Always buy the ammo if you can get the points back. It's not a big deal. Unless you do upgrade your gun, then I would maybe hold out a little. But if you're not gonna, oh fuck, if you're not gonna upgrade your gun, or like you don't have upgraded gun. All right, that fire guy is running at me now. I didn't know he ran. Actually, I take that back. I didn't know he runs. He blows up, so you better watch out. If he's running at you, there you go. If he's running at you like that, I guess after a while he gets pissed and he starts running at you, then you need to kill him, because he's gonna blow up on you. He's gonna be a suicide bomber. He's gonna break you down and blow you up, and you're gonna die. And then it's gonna suck. It's gonna suck. So take my word. Oh fuck. Jack kill the crawler, please. God damn it, I would. Boom. Alright, we have a crawler. Now I'm going to go hit the box, like I said. So like I said, the big rape train. All we need now is the baby ray. And that's pretty much it. So, I forget what it's called. I'm not even going to guess. I'm just going to call it the baby ray. You all know what I'm talking about. But once you get that, the soulless chat is pretty much finished. You've completed what you need to complete, and then you just run around and use the baby ray, and then I'll show you for, I guess, 2 rounds after that. But, you know, to me, this isn't that much fun on solo. It's not, solo is not fun. Play with a friend, play with three friends. Yeah, three friends. I wish they made more people. Hopefully, you know, hopefully Treyarch comes out with a new game. That's from the minecart, if you were wondering. But I wish they would have at least 8 people. That'd be awesome. Or at least 6 people. 6 people would be, like, what I would be excited for. Again, stick with the stakeout. Stick with the 74U. Till we can get the baby ray. And switch out the baby ray for the stakeout. Or you could just upgrade the stakeout if you, you know, I don't know. By round 10, you should either have the baby ray or the stakeout upgraded. And then by round 15, by round 10, you want a good gun as well, or the 74U upgraded. I would say the 74U upgraded, probably. Would be the best. But, so yeah. Oh, there's also monkey bombs. Teddy bear. There's also monkey bombs. Those are helpful. You know how they work. Here's the MP5. So, it, again, I guess, I don't know if I said it, I did a video before this, so I'm not sure if I said it before, if I do apologize, but depending on what gun's your favorite, you could either go this way, get the MP5, or go my way and get the 74U. I just go like going left, because it's the first way I ever went. So that's the way I go. Alright, we need to find this box. Alright, the box is in the spawn. Also, if you guys didn't know, these things are here. Oh, crawler. You can go up those. Not the wrong way. You can go up those things. They'll help you escape as well. So, like I said, the map underneath is a big rape train. You could run the whole map. You could run a section of the map. It's pretty much easy. The main reason of this map, I think, was to, not for solo, but for just some fun. And just so you work on the Easter egg shit. All right, here we got the baby ray. Can I get this? Hearing a guy. Okay. He's gonna spawn. Alright, killed the last zombie. Now, this is what you do. Now, you choose an area that you want. Do you want here? Do you want the smaller area? I like the smaller area. Here. And then all you want to do is fix this window. Get some more points. Have the baby ray out. And then you can just, you know, wait for the zombies to come. Oh, monkeys. Alright, wait for the zombies to come. Then you just run this way. Like this. Go real slow. Run this way. Go real slow. Go slow around the outside, you know, so you get some time. Then, run this way. And then you can just make them. Now that fucked me up because that thing's long. But then just make them all babies and run through them. That's pretty much all you gotta do. I'm gonna end up dying because that shrieker's by me. Now they do hurt you. Which is not always. Oh, fucking shrieker. Shrieker. But that's pretty much all you guys do. That's all you have to do. That's all you have to do the whole time. Now if you want points, just run a bigger rape train. We'll actually show you. I'll show you. Fucker. Alright, you can go this way. So go this way, there we go, and then just get all the zombies behind you and spray into them, get all the points you want, spray into them, get all the points you want. Oh, you fucking bitch, she has hot, she must be black, she must be part black, she was once black. And then just spray on the bridge, and then just don't get overwhelmed. Again, you could do that shoot knife. Try to hit some other. I guess I'll try to hit the box. Think I'm a crawler. There we go. Now I would say buy all your perks. Then buy the flopper. Maybe we'll go buy flopper. Yeah, we'll buy flopper. But that's pretty much the solo shot, guys. Also, real quick, if you're trying to get the box, you can hit this. And it'll make the current come, and it actually pushes you back, but it pushes all the zombies as well, so they can't attack you, they'll fall down, and then, so that can actually help you. Just be careful when you do that, because like I said, it pushes you as well. Then you can just buy all the perks you want, double tap, What's that? Stamina up. Ooh, excuse me. Floppers right here. Flopper also gives you points. And also, if you have the ray gun, I would use a flopper. But that's pretty much it, guys. All you have to do... Oh, I'll show you real quick if you don't know how to upgrade your gun. For those of you that don't know... All you have to do is come right here, stop this spinning head. Like so. Then run this way. Run this way. Come up this thing. Then you run over here. Come up the steps. And then you pack a bunch with your guns. You guys want to see something funny? Look at this monkey. Oh shit, he exploded! Oh shit, he exploded! They come back, so you don't have to worry. But this is pretty much going to be my solo strat, guys. Like I said, all you have to do is get the baby ray, then just run circles. If you need more points, run around the bridge area. But that's pretty much it. You can then upgrade your 74U, get the ray gun. I know you guys don't want to sit here and watch me run around in circles. If you get fucked over, just shoot this thing in front of you. Buy all the perks you want. I would say sleight of hand, quick revive, juggernaut, flopper. And then when you run out of quick revive, buy, I'm not sure. Buy something or other. Then just save up, get the points, upgrade your guns. That's pretty much it. It's really simple. I don't have enough points for the claymores. But you can get spike mores, put them down. Just run this, go to the bridge. So that's pretty much it, guys. This is gonna be the solo strats. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please, please, please give it a like. I usually don't ask for a like, well actually I kinda do, but I usually don't get them. But if you guys could please give it a like, you know, like, you have no idea how much just liking, just hitting that little like button does, like how much that helps out. So I'd really appreciate it if you did that. Really, really appreciate it. And also, if you check out my website, gamevids.com, you can see all my recent videos on both my channels, this channel and my main channel. Hopefully I can bring you guys some more zombie stuff. Martin does not have the maps yet. He said he wasn't buying them, so I don't know. But I will try to do a quad com or a dual live com. You fucker. Ugh. You can also... Does the nuke affect him? Yes. You can also make him the baby as well. The only thing I don't know is I'm not sure if you can, punt him. I'm pretty sure you can because he's a baby. But that's another way to get rid of the big... Well, yeah, because I hit this... Yeah, you already saw it. So if the fire guy comes, just shoot him with the baby ray. Punt his ass and tell him to get the fuck out of here. But that's pretty much it, guys. Like I said, this map isn't that much fun on solo because I'll... You know, you can get everything by level 10, then you're just running rape trains, and I really don't care. Oh, you bitch. I really don't care of how far I can get on solo, because it doesn't matter. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. That's the end of the video. I'm just going to keep running, I guess. I don't know. I kind of don't want to end it. Because I know you're like, oh, why did you end it, GameVids? I wanted to watch you run around. But yeah, so where's the box? Oh, yeah, we'll go down. I'll just show you everything in the map, I guess. How about that? I'll show you guys everything in the map. I'm working on the secrets for those of you that know the Easter egg. I know Next Gen Tactics are doing it, but they're not really explaining it. So I'm gonna do it and explain it because I'm awesome like that. And yeah, so hopefully you guys will keep checking back. I guess, again, just check GameVids daily. I've updated that website so much, and I really really like it, and I'm really proud of myself because of it because. I did it all by myself. Miguar did help me, but then I redid mine. He's been helping me since, so. Oh shit, zombies! The zombies can stand on the thing with you, so you want to be careful with that. But that's pretty much it, guys. You have to wait for that minecart to go back up, just so you know. Just so you know. But you know, get this gun, get the 5,000 points, run the rape train like it was your business. Like it was your job. Run the rape train like it was your job. Maybe I'll activate the song for you guys. And I'll finish this off on a A musical note. Oh, fuck. Musical note. Yeah, let's go. We'll activate this one. Alright, watch this. I'm gonna punt this baby. Ready? Wait for him to get closer. Ugh! Oh my god. Fuck. it's only good for the upgraded one because it makes him stay longer. It makes him a baby longer, so maybe you need the upgraded version to actually be able to punt him effectively. But yeah, so come down here. Oops, I went the wrong way. It's in the spawn room. Oopsies, I forgot where the song was, even though I made a video. Here's another way to run a rape train. Ugh! Ugh! Grunting is the way to make a rape train. Bitch. And then you can, just throw grenades, whatever. You guys know how to run a rape train. I don't need to tell you. I don't need to tell you! If you don't know how to run a rape train, well then you can either, one, watch me, or two, go, YouTube Syndicate, and watch him run rape trains. What was I going to show you? Oh yeah, the music. Alright. Stupid me forgot to get the right one. Right two. Oh, I passed both of them, too. Gosh, I'm stupid. I'll go get them. I promise. I was working on not dying, I guess. Do you guys hear that creature? He's like, ruff, ruff, ruff. Roar. I think he's behind me. So close. There he is. I'm gonna punt him. I like punting him. Punt the baby! Punt the baby! Alright, this worked out good. We'll do it that way. Alright. It's right here. There's number two. And then I'll wait for I'll save crawlers so you guys can actually hear the song. Oh wait, I don't know if I can do that without talking over it. I'll just hit the box then. How about that? I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to do it. Ugh, it's right here. Alright, I'll just talk over it a little. No copyright intended. Nuke. And also, that's why the baby race awesome! Oh, what the hell? I hit my controller on my lap. Oopsies. Oopsies! Alright, so this song's pretty good. I'm not sure who sings it, though, but I like it. I like it a lot. I like it a lot better than Avenged Sevenfold. Sorry, but that song was shit. But, yeah, guys, please give it a like. I know you probably haven't done it because, like, no, fuck you, games. I don't like any of your videos. You're an asshole. You fucking suck at zombies. You can't even make it to level 12, you piece of shit. But, no, seriously, could you please give it a like? I will upload as much videos as you guys want. Well, not really. Not as much as you guys want. But I will upload a lot of videos if you can just get my videos in, like, the 50,000 views or 100. Could you guys give me a 100,000 view video? If you guys could do that, that would be amazing. I will try to upload a lot of things, like Syndicate does. But I'm not going to be putting them in parts anymore. I'm just going to upload them all at once. Because I know you guys don't like parts. And do I have a crawler? I probably have a crawler. Alright. I know you... Fuck! I didn't have a crawler. I know you guys don't like parts, so, you know, I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm just going to upload the whole thing. It'll take a lot longer to upload, and it'll take a lot longer to render. But you guys are worth it, and I love you all. And so, yeah, that's your, you know. But in return, all I ask is you like the video. That's all I ask. In return, you like the video and watch it. That's all you got to do, and I will keep uploading them all in together. And, you know, I'm hoping for 100,000 views, you know. Come on. You can do it. You know, like, watch the video today, and then watch the video tomorrow, and, you know, just, it would help me out a lot. And then I could keep doing these. Oh, also, I forgot to mention, I'm going to mention this real quick. I bought a new computer, which means my render times won't be as long as usual, meaning awesomeness. That's pretty awesome. Yes, it is. But I have to wait. I think it comes Friday. I will be uploading videos. I got speakers for it. Like, I bought speakers with it. They already showed up, and I already made a video of them. But, I kind of didn't really like the video. But I will do an unboxing on my computer. Oh, fuck you. Oh, my God! Alright, punting baby is not always a good idea.
No, punt the babies.
Those babies are assholes. I'm going down right here, guys. Can't fucking reload. Yeah, suck it. Thank God for insta-kill. Insta-kill! But yeah. So I played with Syndicate earlier. We were working on the stuff. Hopefully Syndicate will see this. Hi, Syndicate. I love you. Syndicate Return. But no, I'm not that much of a fanboy. Okay, maybe I am. Syndicate's awesome. I told him to send me some Lucasaid. I was like, Syndicate, send me some Lucasaid. But yeah, so I'm gonna come down here. Gonna upgrade, turn on the upgrade thing. I'm sorry I'm talking another song if you guys want to hear it, but I'm more awesome. But no, guys, I got my computer. Well, I haven't got my computer, but I bought my computer. It is a Dell. I could have bought one, like, made, and like, I don't know, like, separate pieces and stuff. Now you have to find where this thing's at. That's another thing I want to show you, because it sometimes changes. But I wanted to, you know, I didn't really know... Like, I know what I wanted, but I'd rather just buy it right from my company and not have to put it together and all that stuff. Because I'm very impatient. I don't want to wait for, like, oh, my, you know, my case came today. Oh, my hard drive came. Oh, gotta wait next week for my, what's called, where the fuck's this thing? Next week for my, you know, so I just bought it from Dell. It was like $1,500, I think, which is pretty awesome. The one I have now is, like, I just bought a regular one. So this is actually my very first actual PC that I wanted. You know, I maxed it to what I wanted and what I could afford. And I'm really excited for it. It is i7. I think it's a 3.4. I want to say 3.4 gigahertz processor, 8 gigs of RAM. And I know you guys are gonna be like, well, you could have built your own for $1,200. And then I also got a 24-inch monitor. What am I looking for? Oh, the statue. Where is it? I like this music. I like the music in that room. In the cave. Oh, I'm also going to show you guys where the radio is at. Just because I want to see if it shows up after you... Because you can't access night. How are you spinning? You can't access nighttime. Oh, it's getting a little laggy. What the hell? I'm on solo. Why is it choppy? I was supposed to end this a long time ago. I just like talking. See, and this is what I was talking about. It fucking you up. Look at that. Put me right back to the start. Stupid thing. I took you down the slide. I took you down the Minecraft. Here's two. Number three. Oopsies. I cannot remember where the third one is. Why am I so stupid? I could buy that, but I don't want it. I would say buy that, though. Oh, right here. Stupid me. Durr. Durr. I should have known it was here. You have to do something here. I'm not going to spoil it for you guys. But right here's the radio. Actually, I'll go upgrade my gun first, and we'll come back. And then we'll see if I could do this all on solo. The time travel will tell. I don't think so, because there's a lot to it. But we're gonna come up here and upgrade this gun. Did you guys just hear that? What is that goldenrod Richtofen is stroking? If you're as Richtofen, if you're playing as him, you'll see on the bottom, if you guys remember from Call of the Dead, you got that goldenrod. Well, he has it. And we're not really sure why. I'm pretty sure it's like for the time travel will tell thing. But yeah, so it's all a bunch of Easter eggs. Yay, I'm really cold now. Alright, so here we got the HK again. Only take it for what it is. You should always have a spring gun and the baby ray. But we're gonna find that crawler. Kinda cold. I'm gonna be hot in a second though. I wish it wasn't like that, but that's how it gets. But yeah, so what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, the radio. I almost killed him. Ugh, fucker. Alright, come get this radio. Right here. Maybe there's a solo way. The heat and humidity is just excruciating. According to the locals, it is cold. Mountain range just up this river. Gary, do you hear that? A waterfall. Okay, I can't be quiet. I'm sorry. I have ADD. If you guys want to hear what it says, you're going to have to... Oh, excuse me. You're going to have to come find it out. I'll drink some of my my monster. Oh, today, guys. Okay. Today is... What is today? Wednesday. Yeah, Wednesday. It's 5:30 in the morning, just so you guys know. That's what time it is. So the map said... The map said that... I mean, this website that was posted by Vanderhall, whatever the hell his name is. I don't even know. He said... Oh, it said that the maps would come out at 9 o'clock my time. It was... And I found this out at about... I updated it on Twitter. About, 5? Yeah. Like 4:35, okay? Then I was like, well, 9 o'clock is 4 hours. I'm gonna take a nap until 8:30. So I went to bed. And then I woke up at 8, and the maps were out. And the maps came out at fucking 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock. It came out 2 hours. I mean, it came out an hour after I went to bed. I was so pissed. So that's one reason why my videos were delayed. And then I went to bed at 8. Oh, well, I started playing. And at 8, you know, after I got the maps, I started playing. I did my live com, which you hopefully guys already saw. If not... Go to gamevids.com and you can just go through my recent videos and you'll see it there. What am I trying to say? Oh, so I started playing and I thought it was maybe like noon, maybe noon at the latest, and it was fucking 6 o'clock at night. Like I was playing for so long and didn't even know. And then I went to bed at 8 and then I woke up at midnight and I've been up since midnight. Alright, so the radio came on. I guess you can't really do anything at night, so yeah, so that kind of ruins that plan. So what we're going to do is we're going to kill this zombie, then we're going to start running the rape train, again, oh fuck, I fucked it up, there you go. If you hear the things, they make noise, you need them for the Easter egg later on, yeah. Yada yada yada. I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna go down. HK is actually a bad gun. You guys shouldn't get it. Damn it, hammer. Again, you could bait. I wanna show you how to bait that. But I keep ending up getting the shitty power ups. Zombie behind me. I hear him. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not. Shrieker's coming. Haha, fuck it, Shrieker. Alright, let's try to get the ray gun. You should not get the ray gun. But, I just want to do stuff. Hey, was that the Spas? What's some other guns? Alright, leave a comment below. Since you guys are still watching this, hopefully. Hopefully you already liked the video. So I'm going to ask you to do something else. Leave a comment below on what gun would you want to see... in zombies, like if they're like, we're bringing a new gun next round, and I don't mean like a mystical gun, I mean like an actual Call of Duty gun. What gun do you want on zombies? There's actually a lot of guns that aren't in here. And so, yeah. So leave that comment. What gun would you want on zombies? And then another comment would, what gun from any Call of Duty would you want in zombies? I'm not going to answer because I really don't know. But what other gun from any Call of Duty so far would you want? And then another question I can ask you guys is, what if you came up with the mystical gun, what would it do? We already have a shrink ray. We already have the scavenger that just like shoots out an explosive shit. So fuckers. What would the gun? Ah, there we go. What would it do? So leave those three comments below. If you made the gun, what gun from Call of Duty Black Ops would you want in zombies? What gun would you want from any Call of Duty? And if you can make your own gun, what would it do? I don't know if I mentioned this, the monkeys don't kill you. They just, they get pissed that you take their perk, so they bitch slap you. It's pretty funny. I think I did mention that. But yeah, so those three comments, guys, leave them below. I really should stop doing this fucking video. But I just want to keep talking to you all because I love you. I fucking hate this HK. HK is good with double tap, but not double tap. It sucks. Oh yeah. What I was supposed to do is check for the other radios. Stupid me. That's what I was supposed to do. Alright, so I'm gonna know where I'm gonna go where I've seen them and see if they're there. I don't think they'll be there. Because usually you have to do stuff at night. But maybe you could do it in solo and it'd be a lot easier. I'm not sure though. But I think the whole point of not having a solo achievement, like big solo achievement, is they want you to do it with other people, so one, it's harder, and two, you have to play with people. And that way you have to tell your friends to buy their games and all that stuff, so. Is there a way of making more money? It's a smart way. And I had to turn my AC on because I was getting hot. Also, this is a bad thing because I can't hear if the zombies are behind me. I can't see if they're behind me. And they're behind me! Fuck. See, I called that. Don't do that. Do not stop on the bridge. Stupid me. Alright, so. Yeah. Stupid me. Don't stop on the bridge. Oh my god. Oh, alright, I died, guys. Don't punt the fire, baby. Without Juggernaut. But that's pretty much it, guys. I pretty much sabotaged myself. But you understand, as long as you don't turn around on the bridge, you're going to run around the map a billion times. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Please, if you have not already, for one, if you haven't already, you're an asshole. But can you be nice now? And like the video. I'd really appreciate it. And I'll talk to you guys later. Again, check out my website, gamevids.com, for all the awesomeness of my videos. And I'll talk to you guys later. Have a great day, and good luck, and have fun playing Shangri-La. Take care, guys.